This is a video I've wanted to do for a while now, but I haven't been able to find the time until today. In this video, I'm going to explain why the Grudge made no sense. But first, let me say that this is an exaggeration on my part, and the Grudge does indeed make sense, but the sense it makes isn't very good. Now, there are many people who will see this video and react by calling out The Ring, which is still number one in the Japanese to American remakes in terms of horror. However, The Ring made perfect sense within the realm of the first movie. After the second movie, the sense was thrown out of the window. The second movie didn't add anything to the first movie. Therefore, if you only saw the first movie, you would have the story complete. This is going to be a point I'll bring up later on. In order to understand why The Grudge made no sense, we first have to figure out what The Grudge is. The premise of the movie states the following. When someone dies in the grip of a powerful rage, a curse is born. That curse gathers in the place of death. Those who encounter it will be consumed by its fury. Now that's the premise. Here's the story in a nutshell. The Grudge is about a woman named Kieko. Kieko is married to Teiko. They have a son named Toshio. However, Kieko is in love with a teacher who works in Tokyo, named Peter, played for all of 5 seconds by Bill Pullman. Kieko has been following Peter and writing him love letters, and even writes about him in her diary. Anyway, one day, Teiko discovers this diary, and, well, he murders his entire family and hangs himself, thus beginning the curse. That's only the backstory. The actual movie features people entering the cursed house and succumbing to the curse, and they end up being killed. By who, you ask? Keiko! Does this make sense to you? If you remember the premise of the movie, when someone dies in the grip of a powerful rage, a curse is born. That curse gathers in the place of death. Those who encounter it will be consumed by its fury. I don't recall Kieko dying in fury. In fact, if memory serves correctly, wasn't it Teiko who murdered his entire family and killed himself? But, of course, he couldn't have been in the grip of a powerful rage to do that. For the slow crowd, I'm basically saying that Teiko should have been the ghostly entity killing anyone who set foot in his house instead of Kieko. Now, why is it Kieko and not Teiko? Even though he would have been the logical choice. Well, we later learn that Kieko's mother was an exorcist, and Kieko was fed evil spirits to heal the affliction of others. However, you don't get this important bit of information in the first movie. You have to see the sequel in order to understand Kieko's homicidal rage. Remember, like I said, The Ring 2 didn't need to explain any of Samara's backstory because we already knew it. The Ring 2 tried to expand upon it, and that's why it sucked and should have never been made. But we're not talking about The Ring 2. But even then, the explanation given by Kieko's mother doesn't make sense, because Kieko's mother reveals that she isn't responsible for Kieko's ghostly homicidal rage, and that Kieko's homicidal rage was spawned by wanting others to know how she felt. How about how her husband felt when he discovered she was goo-goo-eyed at some pretty teacher boy? Oh, but a thing like that doesn't cause a person to become filled with rage. No. Nope, not at all. Essentially, what I'm saying is that the only character with half a logical reason for killing anyone who walked in the house is Teiko. Kieko's backstory and the story of her childhood just seems lame and forced, and ultimately makes her one of the dumbest, nonsensical ghostly forces ever to appear in a horror story. She has absolutely no reason for killing people. Well, neither did Samara. True, but Samara never really wanted to kill people, hence why she gave them a way out. By copying the videotape and sharing it with someone else, Samara was able to reveal to people how she felt being trapped in a well for 7 days. While The Ring was an allegorical story on isolation and alienation, The Grudge was a ridiculous movie with a few jumps and jerks in it to keep your girlfriend clutching your arm for the rest of the night. Anyway, this has been The Strange Editorial, and once again, I'm Ugo Strange.